Peace be with you, everyone. And thank you so much for being here today. It's been a wonderful week for us. On Monday evening, we were in this room with almost, well, I guess it was 250 high school musicians playing together. And now, tonight, we have the joy of hearing these incredible collegiate musicians singing together from the great state of Ohio. A lot of good things come from Ohio. So I feel so grateful that they're here with us tonight. Before we begin, though, some things to mention. First of all, we are indeed grateful to the season sponsors that allow us to offer all of our Abendmusik programs free of charge. And not only that, but all of them have become fundraisers for other local nonprofits rather than for our Abendmusik series. What a gift that is. And among the organizations and people that are responsible for that, here are these names in particular: the Nebraska Arts Council, Union Bank and Trust, First Plymouth Church, Lorraine Bedell Love, Rhonda Seacrest, the Conant Family Endowment, and the estate of Norma Summerheiser. Will you please join me in thanking all of those season sponsors? And similarly, for tonight's program in particular, we are grateful for the concert sponsors that have provided especially this program, that include the Lincoln Community Foundation, and this may seem a little awkward, but me and my husband, Brent. So please join us in thanking our our concert sponsors. And before we get to the music tonight, we want to take a moment to be grateful to those in our community who help to do so many incredible things to take care of people who need it. And I know our family particularly experienced the good work of the Community Action Partnership of Lancaster and Saunders counties as our kids went to preschool there. And so very thankful for your work. And so tonight, Jesse Hedrick is here to share with us a little bit about the mission of this organization that you'll have the opportunity to support. Please join me in welcoming Jesse.
Thank you so much for having us tonight. As Tom mentioned, my name is Jesse Hedrick. I am the Development Director at Community Action, and we are just so thankful to be the recipient of tonight's generosity. At Community Action, our mission is to empower people living in poverty to reach economic stability. And we provide programs and services in four impact areas to achieve this mission. Those are early childhood education, homelessness prevention, financial and family well-being, and hunger relief and healthy food access. And every year, we serve over 17,000 of your neighbors right here in Lancaster and Saunders counties. First Plymouth in particular is an incredible partner and supporter of our work, especially in our early childhood education programming. And without support from organizations like First Plymouth and people like you, our work wouldn't be possible. And to illustrate the impact of that generosity, I'd like to take just a moment to share with you tonight an excerpt from a letter that was actually written by one of our Head Start teachers about a child in her classroom named Mason. The letter reads, "In every teacher's journey, there will be a child who comes along that changes the way they think and teach, a child who pushes them to be better. For me, Mason is that child. Mason has autism, and when he joined our classroom, he was mostly nonverbal. Bonding with Mason was easy, but learning to communicate with him was a little trickier. We would show Mason things and he would follow and lead him to the table at meal or a small group activity times and he would follow. Eventually, Mason began to sing familiar songs, say his ABCs, and learn his shapes, but he still had difficulty communicating his wants. So we continued to work as a team and with his special education providers to support him in building his communication skills. I vividly remember the first day Mason responded to me. I had taken him to the bathroom, and when he was finished, I asked him, 'Are you ready to go back to the room?' And this time he responded with, 'Yes, yes.' And I think I almost cried that day. Mason has grown so much since joining our classroom. He is showing us something new every day. And while we have supported him in building his communication skills, he has also helped us create a real sense of community where everyone belongs. And our friends in our classroom love Mason. They ask to play with him, give him toys they know he likes, and have become so mindful of the way he communicates. He's changed our classroom community in the best way, and I'm so proud of his progress and can't wait to see that continue. And by supporting community action, you make growth like Mason's possible. So thank you again for having us here tonight.
We've had the privilege here, at least in the years I've been here, to host many of the great collegiate choirs in America. But one of the ones that's been the hardest to get to come out has been Capital University's Chapel Choir. And I have a feeling, friends, that it's going to have been worth the wait once you get to experience the joy and wonder, the precision and passion, the light, and the inspiration that they bring in their music and in the way they carry the message that their music sings and tells. So please join me in welcoming Dr. Lynda Hasseler and the Capital University Chapel Choir.
Good evening. I feel like I should start by saying that I really wasn't playing hard to get with Tom Tranny. And I have been looking forward to this moment of us joining you and your beautiful community here for a long time as well. And in fact, in our communication with each other in the choir and in many of our social media posts, we've been referring to this church and Tom Tranny as our North Star. And we have been following it to have this moment in time, and it's already been such a blessing to be here. So our concert tonight is themed Full of Wonder. Wonder. A feeling of surprise, mingled with admiration, caused by something beautiful, unfamiliar, unexpected, inexplicable. The chapel choir and I have been dedicating ourselves to a theme each year for many years now, and we don't just sing about the theme, but we strive to live it. And in so doing, we deepen our commitment to the transformative power of music and song. It's our hope tonight, as we present and share this concert with you, that it will inspire you to become wonder seekers, people who intentionally seek out things that delight them, someone who's curious and inspired and open-hearted. The first section of the piece deals with texts that talk about wonder in a variety of styles and ways. There's an Appalachian folk hymn, a Southern harmony hymn, an old standard first recorded by Louis Armstrong, a setting of the Latin text O Magnum Mysterium, which has the word wonder in it, it's admirabile. And the text tells a very wondrous story. An inexplicable story, really, how the Savior of the world would be revealed to us and brought to us in a humble manger, and the first witnesses were animals. So we hope, as you listen to this opening set about wonder, that it begins to awaken in you a sense of wonder.
Thank you.
I'm choosing not to compete with that. One of the best portals to wonder that I know and have experienced is travel. So this next set represents travel in two ways, travel in time and travel in place. The places are Spain and Argentina, and the time is Christmas. The first is a setting of that beautiful text, Ave Maria, which tells the story of when Mary receives the news that she has been chosen to give birth to the Savior of the world and to raise him. The composer Josu Elberdin lives in Spain and lives in an area of Spain that the chapel choir will be traveling to this summer on an international tour in June. So we'll have the opportunity also to work with him much the way we worked with a composer today at this church. And it's an experience that, again, deepens our commitment to music making. Then we travel to Spain for a lovely lullaby where the mother is making cooing sounds to her baby and telling even nature to be quiet because she's trying to get the baby to sleep. And then we continue that lullaby with the third verse of the familiar Away in a Manger, where we pray to the baby Jesus to stay with us now and in heaven. And then finally is an Argentinian carol that joyously speaks of what happens when a community of people gather together. So won't you come and travel with us?
Thank you.
the next set of pieces vary a lot. So they're a little different from the first two sets that were crafted to tell a story and weave in and out. The theme running through these set of pieces is the wonder of the creative musical mind, the writer of the texts, and the composers. They're all vastly different, and you get such a clear sense of what the creative spirit is capable of. And it would be a crime to come to this church and not do a piece with organ. And it would be additionally, you know, another sentence if we didn't do a piece with organ with Tom Trenny at the organ. So the chapel choir rehearsed this for weeks. Last semester, we rehearsed it one time with Tom, because that's what a marvelous artist he is. And I wish you could have seen the students' faces light up as soon as he started to play. And then at the end, I mean, really, it was a wonder to behold.
Thank you.
And remember, I said that this set of pieces was about contrast and the vast array of the uniqueness of the choral art, and in this case, the human voice. So the next piece, Tutaranna, is Northern Indian classical style singing. And it's the closest that we might be able to relate to is scat in jazz. When it's taught, it's usually a solo art, the teacher and student. Teacher sings, student sings back, and it gets ever more complicated and rhythmic. In this case, the composer Rina Esmail wrote a tutaranna for choir, and she also coaches in a video how choirs can learn to sing with that unique tone quality of this style of music. It's quite a bit different than our set point of how we normally sing. It's very forward and quite nasal and very fun to have our instruments make a change like that. And I also believe that one of the best ways that we can expand our view of the world and cultures is by experiencing it, by it passing through our bodies. And in this case, it's this sound. So we know you're going to enjoy Tutaranna. Thank you very much. And now we're at a place in the program where we get another great joy of the experience of being here. And that is when we get to join our voices with the voices here. And we had the glorious opportunity to rehearse this today. And so we now have an opportunity to sing with the church choir here Tom Traney's piece, I Will Make a Way, with Tom Traney on the piano. I don't know if it gets better than that, honestly, folks. This was another aha wonder moment for the chapel choir today, because we have been singing this piece all year, and quite well. And as Tom Traney talked to us about the piece, he didn't complain about how we sang it, but he enlightened us. And there's a spirit of the piece that we are missing a little bit. This is about, yes, going through a hard time in the desert and coming out resilient, and all the old has passed away, and everything will be new. And in Tom's way, I mean, you know him, but this uplifting spirit that we were slightly missing, the joy we discovered. So in our pre-concert meeting, the choir mentioned in particular places in the piece that clicked for the first time because he taught us, he showed us the way. I Will Make a Way, Tom Traney.
Thank you.
It's highly unorthodox for me to ask my choir to clap outward, but I'm going to ask them to do that now. Would you thank the choir? So back again we go to the creativity of the human spirit. This is a new setting of Children Go Where I Send Thee. And this is a very, very popular carol to sing at Christmas time, or I shouldn't say carol, but a piece to sing at Christmas time. And I even had a friend tell me when they opened up the program this year for our Christmas festival and saw Children Go Where I Send Thee, they thought to themselves, oh, not this one again, right? But I'm going to tell you that this brand new setting of it is definitely not that one again. Children Go Where I Send Thee. But before we sing that, they're laughing because four concerts in a row, I forget this next part. So before we sing that, we have a small group called Philomel. Philomel is Latin for nightingale, and the nightingale is a songbird, thus their name. And they sing popular repertoire, also all the whole range. And one of our operating sentences this year with wonder is our capacity for delight is our gateway to joy. So, cue the music. And now, Children Go Where I Send Thee. Thank you. Thank you. And the wonder of the last piece on our program is that you get to sing with us. Oops, that didn't work. And the wonder of the last piece on the program is that you get to sing with us. There it is. So this setting of a good old hymn, His Eye is on the Sparrow, and So I Know He Watches Me, was set in a gospel style, and then Rollo Dilworth, who is a very well-known composer and arranger in the choral world, set it for choir. So the beauty of this piece, and we've been singing it everywhere we go, and having the joy of singing with whoever is with us. So near the end of the piece, there's this wraparound refrain. I'm so happy, yes, I'm so happy, yes, I am. And there's a soprano part, and an alto part, and a tenor part, and a bass part. Now, I know all those parts are represented because you've been up here. I am, however, going to ask you to commit because not every one of you are up here. So who are our sopranos among us? Excellent, good representation. Altos, excellent. And by the way, you have to choose one. So. If you're holding back, you better decide soon. Tenors. Excellent. I guess basses, all the rest of you. Raise your hands. All the rest. So how it works is the sopranos will sing those two phrases, and then the sopranos will sing the two phrases back, altos, tenors, basses. Once you've all learned the part, then we'll all sing in four parts together, all right? So, and the reason we're going to do this is we sing because we're happy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. To say a global thanks here at the end before we sing the final benediction for you, which is a special tradition of the Capital University Chapel Choir. So, first and truly foremost to Tom Trenny for being so insistent. I have this picture in my mind of, I'm pretty sure it's the first time I met you, Tom, and I'm not sure where you're sitting, but it was in 2018 when the Chapel Choir sang for a regional ACDA conference, and there were lots of people standing around wanting to say something to me as these things go, and out of the corner of my eye, I see this slight man with a bald head and glasses and a patient smile on his face. And it happens, like, you're gathered with people and you see that somebody's waiting for you, yeah? And he just kept standing there and waiting, and I'd look over him like, I see you, I see you. And then finally we met. And it was, in a way, like we've always known each other. And that's the picture of Tom, patiently waiting, right, for a moment to happen, and then making it happen. So we are very, very grateful. Where are you, Tom, anyway? You're way back there? Okay. So I'm going to let them clap a second time, and you can join them. Let's thank Tom Trenny. And there are lots of people here who helped. Ariel was here when we arrived and showed us to all the rooms, and I'm not going to remember the names, but the sound person and Matthew, who sent the emails, and Phyllis, who is setting up the roommates, and then all of you who made a real potluck dinner for us. I mean, we're just grateful to be here and to have had this opportunity and for this to have been our North Star. And the students are aware of the community that you are, too. They've been looking you up. And so as their teacher, I want to tell you, I'm so glad that as humans, they're experiencing this. Because I do care a lot about how they sing. I care even more about who they are as humans. So thank you for being a model. And again, a star for us to follow. So please know that we are so grateful to you, and that as we sing the final phrases of "The Lord Bless You and Keep You," that it is our hope and prayer. The Lord will indeed bless you and keep you until our paths cross again. We have a special tradition that if there are any alumni of the chapel choir gathered amongst us, they come and join the choir again, because once a member, always a member. Now, I don't know if there are any chapel choir alumni out there. Anybody? Anybody waving? Okay, you're going to have to pretend that you saw some people come up here. How about that? I guess we have to send our students to Nebraska. What I will tell you, in my 30-plus years at Capital, I've seen so many reunions happen. Friends, of course, brothers and sisters, mothers and daughters, mothers and sons, fathers and daughters. I've now been there long enough that I have the children of my first students in the chapel choir. Wave, Ellie, wave. Yep, there she is. So again, this speaks to our deep commitment to community as well. The Lord bless you and keep you.